let's look at the Polk Division action for the week as we mourn the loss of Tom Petty and listen to his sweet songs. Anyway, the first game had Hoskin holding off Upper Turtle during a furious comeback on Monday night. Monkey made the mistake of not starting Williams or Matthews, which would have given him the win. But it was the Texan defense led by J.J. Watt that gave Chucky the win. 24 points for the Texans, for the Pike, and the Pike get the win. Speaking of upset, South Doherty thought they had this one in the bag, but 4 Mile came storming back on Sunday night with 24 points from the Seattle defense. Shawnee thought he had the luck of the Irish and would be able to keep pace with Horseshoe. But no, Bell flashes his first W of the year, and he puts Shawnee's little Irish fucker in a box. Horseshoe remains undefeated by putting up 122 points, a league high so far this year, as he drubbed his older brother, Mike, in the overrated Bro Bowl. You take a look at his scorecard. Mitch isn't going to know who he has to shag next. We got Brady and Bell. But Lil Powell, seriously? So we know his love affair with Tom Brady. We got that part figured out. But now, Le'Veon Bell with his 2.6% body fat. But Lil Powell, oh my God. Mitch has got it all going on. Meanwhile, Dog's mascot wasn't up to the challenge of the day. And Dog called Mitch a twat. Mitch told on him. And now Dog is in timeout. Down to the Barron Division, where it's Apple River pulling away from the rest of the pack. In a battle of two first place teams, Apple River spanking the previously I'm the best in the world touting Wickware Warriors 104-61. You know, guys, it never gets old making my friends look like women. Taking beautiful women and making them ugly as shit. Well, anyway, there's MJ. He likes Jameson. He likes Ezekiel. He's like, ooh, show me that belly, bitch. Anyway, they won. The Maple Grove Beavers continue to score a lot of points and improve to 2-2 with a 96-75 drubbing over Rabbit Trail, who is the only team in the league that remains winless. I know you're sick of the girl references, but who can stop Todd Gurley? And in one of the more bizarre games in league history, Doherty Creek and East River end up with a tie. Neither team getting very many points. Neither team really deserving to win anyway. Needed 2 points from Chris Thompson on a Monday night. Late in the game, he got them. But with no time remaining, he had a flea flicker and fumbled the ball. Strange, I'm taking it really well. It's no problem, guys. Have a good week. Now it's time for our weekly look at the standings, starting with the Polk Division. Here is something that is getting old. It's Horseshoe never losing a game. 4-0, 368 points. 2 games ahead of South Doherty, though they are tied at 368 points, and if they can pick up a couple of wins, they're still in the race. Also at 2-2, the Dirty Dogs, but they're giving up quite a bit in the tiebreaker. And then winners of 2 in a row, Hoskin Pike, and they also are giving up a lot of points in tiebreaker, 144 points back. The 4 Mile Brookies get their first win, 1-3. And then it was the Upper Turtle Flying Monkeys. They're scoring points, but they fall to 1-3 and are behind in the tiebreaker as well. Let's take a look at the weird and wacky Barron Division. There was a 4-way tie for first last week, and of those 4 teams, only one was a winner, and that was MJ's Apple River squad at 3-1. East River goes to 2-1-1 after salvaging a tie with low score of the week, which they shared with, of course, Doherty Creek, because Washington can't keep a fucking flea flicker and loses a point with no time remaining on a Monday night, costing me a win. And then Maple Grove actually has the most points in the league at 2-2. Wickware, greatest coach of all time, 2-2. And there's poor Smiley still looking for a win, 135 points back off the lead. Here's a look ahead to week 5 with spreads. Horseshoe takes on 4 Mile. Surprisingly, 4 Mile is the favorite by 4 points. Because Horseshoe's always lucky and they suck. Wickware, 6-point favorite over Rabbit Trail. That makes sense. Wickware, greatest coach of all time, should be a 6-point favorite.
Then, South Doherty looking for a win. 3-point favorite over the Flying Monkeys of Upper Turtle. Upper Turtle still scoring a lot of points, though. And then moving over to the Barron Division. Maple Grove, 8-point favorites over East River, who's really got a lot of bye issues this week. Maple Grove is the leading scorer in the Barron. Beavertown, only a 1-point favorite over up-and-coming Poskin. Chuck, you think he's going to win the championship? He's like fucking Aaron Rodgers or something. And Doherty Creek, giving up 7 to Apple River. Sure, I'll start guys who either get hurt like right in the first series or they suck. It's your University of Wisconsin Badgers traveling to Lincoln to try to give the old corn cob to Herbie Husker and take down those overrated corn-eating bitches. Saturday night, 7 o'clock. We here at league offices would like to congratulate racist prick Daniel Snyder for changing his team logo. As usual, we here at league offices, Moffato, the Wonder Dog, and the Unified Missioner wish you the very best this week. Au revoir. Must come down. Come down. I'm late.